Welcoming you all, my dear ones. In this video of physical quantities and measurement, I'm going to explain about the topic floating and sinking. Floating and sinking depends upon the densities of object and the liquid in which it floats. So there are two cases. First case, when the object will float, and second case, when the object will sink. If density of the object is less than density of the liquid, then object will float. For example, I have taken here example of cork and water. We know that density of cork is less than density of water, that's why cork floats in water. I've explained you with the help of diagram also. So children, you must draw a diagram in your notebook on internet. Now case 2. If density of the object is more than or greater than density of the liquid, then that body will sink. For example, I have shown here an example of iron and water. Since the density of iron is more than density of water, therefore it sinks in water. But if we are comparing the density of mercury and density of solid, we will see that density of mercury is more than density of iron. That's why iron floats in mercury. Here it is given that density of water is equals to 1 gram per centimeter cube and density of iron is 7.8 gram per centimeter cube, while density of mercury is 13.6 gram per centimeter cube. So you can see in first diagram iron sinks in water. Why it is sinking? Because density of, you see the diagram, first diagram, where you can see iron piece at the bottom inside the water, because density of iron is more than density of water. In second diagram, iron floats. Why? That liquid is mercury and density of mercury is much more than density of iron, that's why it floats there. Okay. In other words, we can say that if relative density of any substance is greater than 1, then body will sink. And if relative density of any substance is less than 1, then body will float. How you will understand this thing? You just take example of iron, water and mercury. If I am going to write relative density of iron is equals to density of iron upon density of water. Here density of water means denominator is less than numerator, naturally the value will be more than 1. So here iron will sink. But in second case, if I am going to write down relative density of iron is equals to density of iron divided by density of mercury, you will see their denominator value is more than numerator. It means that value is less than 1, their body will float. Again I will explain this topic during my numerical parts. Now coming to the applications of this property of objects and liquid, that first use or application, you can say that to measure the density of a liquid directly, we are using hydrometer. A hydrometer is usually made up of a glass, which you have seen in last slide, and consists of a cylindrical stem with graduation and a bulb weighted with mercury or lead to make it float upright. The liquid to be tested is poured into a tall jar and the hydrometer is gently lowered into the liquid until it floats freely. The point at which the surface of liquid touches the stem of hydrometer is noted. This reading gives the relative density of the given liquid. Hydrometer is also used to check purity of milk and to check whether the lead battery is fully charged or not. This battery is mostly used in vehicles, four wheelers. Now second application, an iron nail sinks in water but an iron ship floats in water. Reason behind this is, it is because bottom of iron ship has huge cavity filled with air, which reduces the average density. As the average density of ship becomes less than density of sea water, so it floats. Now Our third application is flotation of submarine. What is the reason behind this? A submarine is provided with blast tank. When this blast tank is filled with water, its average density becomes more than density of seawater. So it dives into the water, but when the water is forced out from its blast tank, its average density becomes less than density of seawater. So submarine rises up to the surface of water. Children, few applications I have chosen with the help of your course book so that you don't forget to be linked with your course book. Okay, so next application is flotation of man. It is easier to swim in sea water than in river water, and you all knew why, because sea water contains dissolved salt also. That's why its density increases as compared to the density of normal water or river water. So the same reason is written here. The reason is that the sea water contains salt, and so its density is more than the density of river water. The weight of the man gets balanced by the less immersed part of his body in seawater as compared to that in river water. Thus, it is easier to swim in seawater than in river water. Next application is flotation of ice on water. A piece of ice floats on water with its 9/10 part inside the water and only 1/10 part of it outside the water. The reason is that the density of ice is 0.9 gram per centimeter cube or 900 kg per meter cube, while the density of water is 1 gram per centimeter cube or 1000 kg per meter cube. Hence, the weight of water displaced by 9/10 part of ice immersed inside the water becomes equal to the total weight of the ice piece. Here, one thing I want to mention, children, that I think I have seen somewhere in your this chapter that density of ice is given 0.09, which is not correct. Density of ice is 0.9. Here in this paragraph it is correctly written, that is 0.9 gram per centimeter cube, but I think in the paragraph of iceberg it is given 0.09. so be perfect about the density's value. Okay, coming back to the topic, these are the two applications with the help of book. In my next slide, I have given few more examples. Next application is about icebergs. I hope you all have seen movie Titanic. As I read the name icebergs, I have taken name of Titanic movie. When we will meet in the classroom, I am going to ask you why I have correlated icebergs with Titanic movie. And I hope my all students must be able to give me the answer. Okay, so I'm going to explain that. Very huge and large piece of ice floating on sea water are called as icebergs. They are dangerous for the ship. The reason is that the density of ice is less than the density of sea water. The density of ice is 0.09 gram per centimeter cube, and the density of sea water is 1.02 gram per centimeter cube. Hence, an iceberg floats in sea water with its large portion submerged inside the water and only a little portion of it above the surface of water, as shown in this figure 2.12. Thus, a ship can strike the invisible part of iceberg under the surface of water. Hence, it is dangerous for the ship, which is icebergs. So children, if someone will ask you that when you are going to drink any cold drink or soft drink, why ice floats? Because density of ice is 0.9 gram per centimeter cube, while water is 1 gram per centimeter cube. So it is lighter, density of ice is less, that's why it floats. Okay, now next application about whales and balloons. The whales can sink or rise at their will. Whenever they want, they can sink, they can rise up at the surface of seawater. Whales are the sea animals. They have a special organ in their body. It is just like submarine blast tank. Whales have a special organ in their body which is called the air bladder. In order to come to the surface of water, they fill the bladder with air. This decreases the average density of the whale, and so it rises to the surface. To dive into the sea, they empty the bladder. This increases the average density of the whale, so it sinks. Okay? If we are going to compare whale and blast tank, that is of submarine, The functioning is just opposite. Here whale fills its bladder with air, then its density becomes less. In case of submarine, when blast tank is filled with water, its density becomes more. Okay. Now we are going to discuss about balloons. A hydrogen filled balloon rises in air. The reason is that the density of hydrogen is less than the density of mixture of gases, that is air. Therefore, the buoyant force experienced by the balloon due to air becomes greater than the weight of the balloon. Hence, the balloon rises up under the influence of the net upward force. So, I'm going to finish this video, children. Very soon I will be here with my new video, and I hope that will be of question answers. And please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Its name is Let's Learn with RK on YouTube. And please press like button, and don't forget to press bell icon. Thank you for your support. Bye bye.